fashion world. Backstage with the models, chaos reigns. To get them made up, coiffed, and dressed, the assistants run around madly in a space overflowing with hangers, makeup cases, and people. These young girls, emblems of elegance, are really just adolescents, high school kids before their final exams. As for Carl, he remains cool, despite the journalists, cameramen, and photographers. Ten o'clock in the morning. It's the final rush. The show is about to begin. Carl, with the help of his colleagues, checks everything. The accessories, the jewels, the hairdos, everything. Maybe it's a way of avoiding stage fright. For KL, his ready-to-wear line, Carl is more audacious than for Chanel. In 1990, he mixed everything, evening skirts in organza with fitted day jackets in wool. No buttons here, just large safety pins. And the final blow, not a high heel in sight, just the same sandal from morning till night. No plain stockings either, legs of all different colors. The collection inspires applause upon applause. Backstage, there's no time to appreciate it, but everyone knows that once again, Carl has conquered. Once again, the audaciousness of Carl's imagination, the class and elegance of his show, have seduced the public. When it's over, the comment most often heard is, how does he do it? And indeed, how does he manage to successfully create collections as different as those for Styleman, Fendi, Chanel, and his own KL?
I like the idea of being like three persons. That's perhaps more a secret than a talent, but it works for me, and I must say I like life like this because I'm easily bored, and to be one than more person stimulates me for everybody, in fact. For me, designing is like breathing. I don't think about it. I do, Hamad. For KL, I do two expensive ready-to-wear collections and two less expensive in Germany. For Fendi, I do a fur collection and two ready-to-wear collections in Italy and a cruise collection. Then I do a KL collection in Japan, twice a year also. Then I do a men's collection in Italy twice a year also. Then I do Chanel, what means two ready-to-wear and two couture. And that, I think, is all.
While the collections are successful with the media and the buyers, the effort is actually directed at another audience. In effect, it is not the some 4,000 private clients in the world who can afford sumptuous evening gowns that make these companies profitable. They and the media make the reputation, perhaps, and it's the reputation that sells the high-volume products, perfumes, accessories, and ready-to-wear. These items, sold under the label of the parent company, are what bring in the real profits. The luxury of high fashion serves to promote these sales of more affordable products. But Chanel has a different policy.
Chanel is not depending on that because they don't do licensing business. Whatever Chanel does is done by themselves. They do their own handbags, they make their own jewelry. Chanel is one of the few couture houses with no licensing. They own all the operations, the boutiques and what they sell in the boutiques and the perfume. So for them it's good for the image, but they are not waiting for people to propose them licensing business. You know, I work for so many companies that would make a lot of shares, and I share the benefit of flat fees. I prefer that, you know. I have no family, so always it starts with me, it ends with me. So what can I do with shares? I don't care for that. I like to have an important fee and an important percentage. And it's much better like this, and it's healthier in my way to see life. I don't even invest my own money in my own business, never.
Carl is speaking in the garden of his home in the country not far from Paris. This spacious home belonged to a famous French actress in the 50s and to an English lord before that. Like all his homes, this one he decorated entirely himself. Each home is a personal creation, as he designs all the fabrics as well as the wallpaper.
I liked it and I bought it like you buy a piece of furniture in the second. I wanted to look like it what it is, the little pavillon as they used to call it in the 18th century, because this house is from the 18th century. The main base was built in 1749, but it was changed by an English man in the middle of the 19th century, and he was the one who built the atelier, and they say that Queen Victoria came here and posed for him because he was a kind of social portrait painter.
Another of Carl's homes is in Monaco. It was a ruin when it was given to him by Prince Rainier. He has turned it into a magnificent palace, but his busy life doesn't allow him the chance to spend much time there. We feel his presence, though, in the luxurious salons and refined bedrooms. The house is filled with photos he has taken of the royal family of Monaco, and particularly Princess Caroline, his friend, who often poses as well for his fashion photos. From his window, Carl can see the royal palace on the other side of the Bay of Monte Carlo. Princess Caroline, a patron of the Monte Carlo Opera, asked Carl to design costumes for the ballet and the opera. During the screening of a tape of one of the performances, Carl, next to Her Highness, has a rather royal allure.
Goethe said something very clever. He said, to make a better future with the enlarged element of the past. I think that is really the main idea of my life. But I don't live in the past, and I think the future is very interesting, and what's going on in the world is fascinating. I like the idea of the past, but only the past I had not known. I don't care for the past I had known.
If Carl is not a man of the past, he is nonetheless a specialist of the 18th century, and he is considered an expert on the furniture of this period by the most important antique dealers in the world. Though extremely busy, he is never in a hurry. He takes the time, wherever he is, to do what he wants to do.
I was right at the beginning very impressed by his personality and his cultural background, and also with the view he looks at music, at film, at art, at culture. I think he knows a lot, and I think he's living in the middle of the world, although it seems that he is away from the world, but I think he's middle, right in the middle of the world.
Lower the face. Das Gesicht ein bisschen tiefer. Claudia, das Gesicht etwas tiefer. Claudia, das Gesicht etwas tiefer.
Carl is a contemporary artist who uses today's tools of expression. In Deauville, in France, he is photographing the Chanel 1991 summer collection. He's doing these photos with Claudia, the internationally famous fashion model. These photos will appear in magazines all over the world.
When I was very young, I wanted to become a portrait painter or an illustrator. But as my mother said, you are born too late for this kind of job. In our times, nobody needs portrait painters or illustrators anymore. And I think she was right. But when I do photos, it's in fact like going back to my first ambition.
On fabulous seaside locations with luxurious stables, Carl directs the models with pleasure and humor, but also with a drive that keeps everyone busy until after night has fallen. What's more, he's shooting the summer collection, and it's the middle of winter. They all have to pretend it's hot. Today, Carl is a professional photographer. For him, photography is a real passion. He shoots the clothes for the catalogs and publicity campaigns, but also his friends, celebrities he likes, his homes, and himself on occasion. Recently, he started showing in galleries like this one in Düsseldorf, Germany. Carl's passions is designing costumes for film. Stéphane Audran, star of Babette's Feast, which won an Oscar for Best Foreign Film, is his favorite actress. He designs her costumes for the screen.
Carl is a real chameleon. He hides behind, he doesn't come forward, and yet it's always him, you see. It's him. It's not just anybody. But his way of adapting to the script, to the actor, to the character, it's fabulous because he has a great sense and knowledge of cinema, that's for sure. Great knowledge of music and of history. He can tell you in 1840, women dressed like this, they had gloves like that, and they talked like this and ate like that. This is what they did, what they thought. What's important is that he doesn't look in magazines, and that makes for real human beings. Carl also has a brilliant painter's eye. He knows how to mix colors, and there is really the artist's creation. That's why, of course, from the point of view of cinema, he has a sense of graphics, a fantastic sense of what will really work on screen. Because there are things that look great on you in real life that look completely ridiculous on screen. I was immediately struck with his ability to right away imagine you in a scene, in a certain setting. I shot a scene in Senegal. I'm sure he's never been there. And in the film, Tavernier's film Coup de Torchon, he made me a very flowing robe because he told me, there'll be a breeze and you'll be on a terrace. And you would have thought he was a fortune teller because just like he'd said, there was a breeze, there was a terrace, and the robe fluttered in the wind. It was marvelous.
I do not know what his motivation is, but I can only say that with the easiness he designs, for me it is unbelievable. And there seems to be so much creativity in this man that it must come from his stability, I think.
What do you think has been the key to your success?
You know, it's not the key what's important, it's a different keyhole, so you have to open the right doors.
I think it's very important to have always new dreams, because, you know, the most important thing for me in life is not the success or what you achieve, but it's the way to do those things. Because to be successful in one thing and then stay with it, it can only degrade. It has to be always something what stimulates you, what makes you curious, that makes it you want to go ahead, whatever it is.
How important is money for you? Could you live on just a little?
You know, what is money? What is little money? It's another question. You can always live with little money, but if is there a little more than little money, you can live with it too. Money is not an important. I like money not for money. I like money as a key to freedom, not as something you put in the bank.
These are the words of a free man. As for his fortune, you only have to look at his homes to understand where it all goes. For Karl Lagerfeld, there's one thing of great value he's acquired in life.
The trust in myself. When collections are over, the only thing I want is to start immediate again, and I always start a new collection the day when I showed a collection. And I even have much more enthusiasm and energy today for my job than I had when I was young. Fashion is still what I like best. Designing is for me a real pleasure. There are many other things like photos and illustration and whatever I do and reading. They are stimulating, but what I really like to do is to design collections, be in a studio, fit them, make the show and start all over again. This is really perfect for me.
Gianni Versace uses the corset to shape his spring 95 silhouettes. The new Versace jacket has wider shoulders, a rounded bust, and a nipped-in waist to emphasize womanly hips. To soften his silhouettes, Versace does feather-light dresses for both day and night. He cuts them body tight or drapes them beautifully on the bias.
Lots of white is one of my first collections without a lot of color. There is a lot of pastel and blue and white and beige. It's new for me.
Why white as an alternative to black?
Yeah, I think it's exactly what is black for winter is white for summer.
Have you used white in many fabrics?
Yes, this collection is based on three fabrics, in jersey, wool and cotton. Very simple fabric, and the use I did is very different. I pleated and I cut on the bias.
Is it close to the body?
No. It's very soft, very loose, very romantic collection. It's a new approach for me. It's less construction in a way and a lot of construction in another way. It's the mixture of the two who make the line.
So the construction is still in the jacket?
Yes, in the jacket, and the skirt or the dress is very loose, very soft, very transparent.
You feel for the length of the knee?
Yeah, in a certain kind of dress, with the fitted jacket, but not in all. I always prefer to give individuality to the women who wear and understand what she looks best on her.